it's your stuff is crap and my stuff is stuff.
Okay, now, what we've got here is the race apron.
This week on Auto Resto Mod, we polish up the Punisher with a hot new race apron from our friends at National Parts Depot.
National Parts Depot has your next wheel. This high-quality steering wheel is made to closely replicate the original EFFEI wheel that came on all 1967 Shelby Mustangs. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford truck and Bronco, Chevy truck, Mopar, and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
I'm tired of working on your crap.
We're working on my stuff today. Wait. Why is it that my stuff is crap?
Because it's your stuff.
So that means your stuff is crap.
No, your stuff is crap.
Well, your stuff is my crap. It's your stuff is crap because my stuff is stuff. In any case, race apron is in from the guys at National Parts Depot.
Yep.
And fenders are in from National Parts Depot. So we've been waiting on some other stuff to show up. Streeter Track's going to be doing something with us, but they're so busy selling parts that they haven't had enough time to put our stuff together. They're not able to get everything done yet. So we're just going to go ahead and do the fenders and the hood and the apron because I'm really tired of this thing, piece of crap sitting
piece
in my
stuff.
See, it doesn't work as stuff. It works as crap. Anyway, I'm tired of this sitting in the front yard with nothing on the front end. I'm sure the neighbors are probably looking at my house going, it's slowly but surely turning into a junk pile.
Especially if they see all my other cars.
I know.
Only one of them has a hood.
Is it with you and no hoods?
I don't know. Better cooling.
No, it's just, never mind. First, I kind of want to go over what we had to do to get it to the position where it is right now.
Yeah. Because there's a lot.
There was a lot, yes. All right, well, I'm going to move around.
All righty.
Okay, so what we're working on here is we're going to be putting fenders on along with putting the race apron on the car, putting the headlight buckets back in the car, and putting the hood back on the car. So it's going to be a fairly involved process. Now, I'm not going to do too much with putting the fenders on the car. Now, Cam's car had some damage along this rail. This rail should run fairly flat on a 65.6 Mustang. If this rail is not flat, you're going to have some problems with installing the fenders because the fenders can actually buckle and bow on these bolts if you're not careful. If this bolt is sitting very much lower, or this bolt, than the rest of the fender, it can cause some problems for that. So make sure you go in like we did and work these fender areas. I worked this and pulled this section up and kind of worked this back section to pull this back up into position. And I went in on the other side and worked the fender mounting bracket over there as well. All this stuff needs to be looked at while you have the sheet metal off the car. Again, you're going to want to put the fenders on, dry fit everything, put the hood back on even so that everything is in position and you know where everything's going, and that way you can make sure everything's going to fit correctly. What you always want to do when you're putting fenders or anything on a car for the first time that are new or even new to you off of another old car is to test fit things. Now, for instance, we've put two bolts in on the top of the fender line here so that we can see what we have. And we didn't push anything. We didn't try to shove anything into position. This was all set very lightly just so I could see what I've got. And what I've got right now is a problem right here and something at the back of the fender that we're going to need to work on these. Anytime you're putting fenders on a car, I don't care what you're working on. If it's an original fender, you may have fitment issues. Don't go and just jam everything on there and try to push it into place. Usually this stuff should pretty much fall where it needs to be. And if it's not, you may have something you need to work on. So always go in and take a look at this. I'm going to keep moving on these. I know I wasn't going to talk about fenders, but I felt like that was important and you guys would want to know.
Well, Jeff, looks like you've done this time or two.
A couple. And one thing I want to say to you guys is if you are interested in us doing an episode on the fenders, on how to align them and set them up on a 65.6 Mustang, please go ahead and put it in the comments below so we can know that that's something you want to see in a future episode. We're probably going to go ahead and do it anyway because there's a couple of things I found on these repop fenders that we're going to need to go over. But if you're interested in seeing it, let us know in the comments. Okay, now what we've got here is the race apron. Yep. And this is the race apron without the turn signals in it.
Without turn signals.
Which you ordered.
Yes. Not my problem. I know where I'm going.
It's the other people I'm worried about. Okay, so what we're going to need to do then is we're going to need to get you some headlights that actually have the turn signals on the bottom edge of the headlights.
Yes.
I've seen them out there. They're going to be, they'll work for what we're doing here.
Yep.
The one thing I will say about these race aprons is this is basically pulled from the Shelby molds. And when you get this thing in, if you flip it over, you will note that there is absolutely nothing on the back of this, no holes in all the positions that you're gonna need them in. And that's what we're gonna go over right now. When we start doing the install on this thing, we're gonna actually have to bore our holes into the race apron itself. So we need to get this thing and dry mount it. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use these clamps to set the ends of this thing and then go in and mark where our hole position is so that we can put this in for final. Well, not final. This is actually all we're doing at this point with this car is going in and doing dry sets to know where everything needs to lay. So we know when we put this car back together for a finish that everything's gonna fit like it's supposed to. Because you know, this car is such a nice car. Anyway, let's get busted on this, dude. All right, now I've got this on here for a test fit. With the reproduction headlight buckets mounted to the reproduction fenders, we are running into a little bit of a fitment issue. Now, I think probably when this thing was set up, it was designed so that you could go in and do some trim work. We're talking about fiberglass, it's pretty easy to cut down. And I'm running into the bottom of the headlight bucket over here before this thing pushes all the way back in. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually mark a line on here to cut on both sides that's down a little bit below there and then pull it all the way over to right out here. It looks to me like when we do this that we're gonna probably also have to trim the very end of this. That's what this kind of stuff is all about. This is a fiberglass part. It's gonna require some fit and fiddle to get it to work. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna take a carpenter's L. I'm gonna put it up in here and I'm going to mark my line about right there. And that should work good enough. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take small bites. I'm not gonna cut this thing out. We'll do the same thing on the other side in just a minute. I wanna get one side set up where I'm happy with it because the fiberglass is flexible enough that I can roll it out and get it out of the way on one side while I'm working on the other. And then I'm gonna put this back in here and remeasure it and fit it so that by the time we're done, our gap here will have closed up and we should be able to go ahead and mark our bolt holes and get this side set up. Then we move to the other side and get it set up on that side of the car. All right, pull her out.
I scratched the paint.
I got Cam working on a couple other things right now, and what I was looking at is this, is it looks like a reproduction headlight door here is probably a little kicked out at the bottom. The distance from the radiator core support to the bottom or the back edge of this door seems a little funky to me. So we're gonna probably have to work on that some, because right now as it stands, this apron is not gonna fit. I'm gonna have to cut all of this out in order to make it fit on the driver's side. Passenger side fit may be okay. It's not actually sitting on the core support at all. So in other words, this one can still go back quite a bit. I'm gonna make a look at it and see what we get. We may have to do some other mucking about though. I'm gonna probably have to take that headlight door off and tweak it. I'm beginning to think that maybe we should have done a video on how to fit reproduction parts onto an original car. Because right now, That's been our biggest struggle today so far. We've done a lot of off-camera stuff that just hasn't panned out on this with these reproduction fenders and the reproduction headlight doors. The fenders look pretty good. I think we can make them work okay, but it's just a matter of these things, which we've done an episode on a while back. I'll put the URL down here for you to take a look at. These things don't fit real well on the car. So what we're still going to do is I'm still working toward an end here, but we've got some
issues.
I even have subscriptions on this car. So I'm going to go ahead and do my cuts on this side, see if I can get this to lay in a little bit better. All right, I'm going to take this off and cut this side down a little bit. Up and at him! Moogie! Okay, now I've gone in and worried out, so to speak, the passenger side of the car. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a old Dr. Pepper, my favorite drink in the world, an old Dr. Pepper box to make a template from. Sometimes this can work pretty good. The only thing is you're limited on length. Craft paper, that kind of stuff, all that can work, but this is a little stiffer. Sometimes it makes it a little bit easier. I'm just going to cut this out. I'm not worried about super precision here because this is not going to be super precise. We're going to need to get it kind of in an ish, and then we'll work it from there. And then I'll use my white marker that we got from Larry to mark the line out on this. Again, I'm not going for super precision on the bottom cut either. This is just to get me in the neighborhood. I'm actually going to lay this a little higher than where it probably needs to actually do a final cut. All I'm trying to do is to get this where I can lay it in. The one thing I will say about these Shelby valances is that every picture I've seen of a Shelby valance on the internet and anywhere else, they're not great fit. They don't exactly fit like I would want them to in putting them in the car. So just keep that in your mind when you're doing this. There's a couple of different ways you could set this up. Your car, it may slide right in there, although I'm gonna guarantee you that you are gonna have to make these kind of cuts on it. But what I'm telling you is, never cut all of what you think you need to cut immediately. Cut it short of where it needs to be, and then go in and start whittling away on it, because these things are fairly easy to slide off and on the front end of the car, and then worry it into position, so to speak. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and mark this up with my marker, lay it in position here, actually over like that, and I'm going to set this in. Because a lot of times on these old Mustangs, things are different from side to side on the car. If you look at what we've got right here, on the passenger side, this cut that we put in here could have probably been made about right here, so it tucked up in real nice next to the headlight bucket. But we didn't do that, so what we're gonna do is just mimic that with an angle cut on this side to match what we got on the passenger side. And it actually dove in and popped up a little bit and went straight across. And then you have to go in and tick the end of it off. At least we did on the passenger side. We may not have to do that over here. Not real sure. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my Dremel tool to make my cuts here. It's a lot easier, in my opinion, to work with those small blades than using a large, like a, you know, 4-inch grinder with a cutoff wheel on it. Just a lot less bulk to have to deal with. So I'm gonna make those cuts right now. I'm gonna use a mask and put my goggles on because, quite frankly, the wheels can break off and come up and come and attack your eyes, and I just don't like breathing fiberglass dust. Call me foolish, or smart.
Luke, I am your father.
Sorry. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a fan behind me to blow the fiberglass dust out the door. This is going to be a little loud. All right, it's going to be time for another test fit now to make sure and see if we got what I think we've got. Pretty good cut. Hopefully this will lay in nice. Won't have to do too much more to it.
Okay.
Passenger side's got good fit. We're way up in the air on the driver's side on this apron that's probably going to have to be mucked around with a little bit. Position is good in the center. Probably going to have to go in and mess with the radiator core support. A little bit of a lump here, and I think that may be holding it out a little too far away for my taste, although it doesn't seem to be affecting it too much. It could be a case where, do you cut the fiberglass or do you work the radiator core support? That would be entirely up to you. I'm going to try working the radiator core support. Got good fit, so now I'm going to try to go in and start clamping this into position so we can start marking our holes for mounting. I'm a little worried about the driver's side right now, but that's one of the ones that we're going to be working on here in just a second. So, good position so far. I'll have to call Cam in here, and we're going to go in and start doing our mount-ups. Down here. All right, now we've gone in and made our template and cut our sheet steel for it for the other side. Now, one thing I'm going to do on this side is I'm going to change my positions just a little bit because I'm too far over on the edge. There's two ways you could possibly do this when you're putting these backing plates in, and I recommend doing a backing plate on the race apron because it just gives you a bigger place to spread the load out on the backside of this, and you're not putting a nut right up against the fiberglass. So if you do have any vibration on the front end of the car, you're not chewing into the fiberglass, you're actually just sitting on this sheet steel and it's spreading that load out a little bit more. Now, what I do recommend doing is this. When you have your sheet steel like this, so what you'll want to do is you'll want to use a longer bolt. Like this bolt is probably right at a total length of 1.5 inches. So you want to use a longer bolt, and that'll allow you to get up in here when you're throwing this thing up on the car, because what you're fighting is the width of your fiberglass plus the plate plus the sheet metal that's on the car already for your fenders. When you're doing that, it's a lot to have to work through. If you can shove a bolt that's a little longer down through there, back it up with a nut like this on the sheet metal, then you should be good to go, because what you'll be able to do then is this nut will sit on the backside, the sheet metal will sit flat against the fiberglass, and you're not going to have an eat-through problem like you possibly could have otherwise. So that's how to do that. Now, basically cutting this out, you can use a set of 10 snips. That's actually what I did here. I use 22 gauge. I would probably, thinking about it now, go back in and do this with maybe 16 gauge sheet metal just to make sure the metal's a little bit thicker to give it a little bit more punch to spread that load with. The 22 gauge can tend to be a little bit shy of what you need. Of course, this is the Punisher and it's Cam's car, so I'm okay with it. All right, so that's what we're gonna do now is basically I'm gonna go ahead and make the other bracket up, and then we're gonna go ahead and mount this thing up and see what we've got. I have a sneaking suspicion we're gonna run into some issues getting this thing to mount up the way I want it to mount, but let's cross our fingers and hope for the best. Sheet metal time. All right, so I've made my template, and I'm probably gonna have to work this a little bit, but what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just lay it up in here and see what I've got. And one problem you can run into with fiberglass, especially on these race aprons, is the fact that sometimes the outer lip edge close to where your bolt holes are going to mount gets way thicker. And you may have to go in and do a little bit of relief work in here to make this fit. I wouldn't do a ton. I would try to put this in here and get it as close as I could without having to take much out. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my unibit here. And we went in and actually mounted the race apron up, use some clamps to set it in position, and then mark this with a mark stick so that we can know where the holes are supposed to lay roughly in the race apron for our mounting position. So I'm going to take the unibit and bore out these. I'm going to probably go a little bit bigger than the bolt so that we have enough room that we can move this around if we need be. You'll notice that this top one up here is actually a slotted hole. It's going to be a little tougher to cut that one. I'm going to cut one side and then try to go in and hit the other side. Because this is fiberglass, once that unibit bites, it goes. Okay. My hole on this is much thicker on this end than it is on this end, so that when I put my template up in here for mounting, I've got a lot of angle to this. Now what that would do is, with my actual nut that goes on the back side of this, is going to kink that around and put a lot more tension on this side than on this side. So I'm going to try to go in and use a Dremel tool, and I'm going to relieve that a little bit on the inside. That'll probably be good enough for what we need to do here. All right, we're gonna do a test fit without any of the bolts or anything in to see what we got here. I'm a little concerned about the way this dives in, but I think that this is a fender problem more than a race apron problem on this side.
This side's way out.
Go ahead and put yours in position, see what we get. See, it's kind of needing to be rocked in and down a little bit.
But,
and I think that we may have an interference problem like right here on the core support. I think when it's rocking in, it may be popping that out a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna try going ahead and mounting it up. I'm gonna go in and knock that in some with a hammer, and then we're gonna try remounting it. But this is what it's all about. I mean, you're gonna go in and fit and fiddle this thing several times before you get it right where you want it. And it's fiberglass. It's going to be a little funky sometimes trying to get fiberglass parts to mount up on sheet metal parts. And this race apron is no different than anything else. You're going to have to monkey around with it to make it fit. After we do this and I knock that in a little bit, we're probably going to mount this thing up for final. We can't paint our brackets today because it's raining outside, but we're going to take these off one at a time, take them out and paint them on Monday, and then have those back in there for final. All right, well, let's pull it up and out of the way, and then we'll remount it.
For the 13th time.
All right, we've done a little bit of sanding for more fit and fiddle.
There's a lot of that on this.
Fiddling around a lot. It's fiberglass, dude. It's just how the nature of this stuff works.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's about as good as we're going to get. I'm happy enough. All right, well, let's go ahead and pull this back off for just a second. I'll get in position. You can lay this down to where I can get to it, and I'll get one side bolted up, and then I'll let you get the other side bolted up.
Alrighty.
All right, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to put the race apron up in position. I'm going to use my longer bolts on it. So Cam's going to hand it down to me, and we're going to try to set this thing in and see what we run up to. It's really disconcerting to see that coming at my face that way. If you see a cat running around in the background in the shots, that's Shop Cat.
All right, you got it?
No, but let's do it anyway. The only bad thing I will say about doing this with the nuts is it's trying to get all these things to feed in at the same time, particularly if you're by yourself trying to do this. That's what I did the other day. All I really want to do at this point is just get this thing mounted up a little bit. Now we're going to do one side and then do the other. I'm going to go ahead and get my bottom bolt started up too, leaving it loose. Okay, now what we've got here is this is actually fitting up pretty good now that we've got it tightened up good and tight. But we've got a real issue right here, and oddly enough, this isn't a problem with the race apron. This is a problem with the actual fender that we've got here. This actually needs to come in and over and down a little bit, and what I'll probably do is pull this fender in, because we've got enough room in here to move. I'm going to pull the fender out as far as I can get it, and then tighten it up real quickly and try to get this to work. You're going to have a problem with fenders no matter what. Most of the time, my experience has been that when you buy fenders, even used fenders, that a lot of times this area will get kinked over when people are moving them around or just doing general stuff with them. When they come in from a shipping place, this area right here is going to have a problem. There's a kink right here on this fender, and that's going to always be an issue, because I'm going to tell you right now that you're going to have some problems here, because this hole can create a weak spot and cause this fender to cave in an upward angle like this. So the problem we're having right now isn't actually the race apron. The problem we have is the fender. be advised on that because it can be something you can deal with even with used parts. All right, Cam, go ahead and get your side tightened up. Good luck with it.
I don't need luck. Because I'm a boss. Oh, and I dropped the bolt.
Some boss.
I never said I was a good boss.
All right, so now the fun side. What I'm doing here is I have my backing plate. I'm going to keep the nut in my two fingers here. So stick the backing plate in. I have the bolt already through the fender. I've got my thumb on it so that I can turn it, push the valence to it. Remember which side you need to turn it to. And you're good. And then take your other nut and bolt. Stick them through, line them up. All right, now that you got that tightened up. So what do we do now, Jeff? You're the body man.
Well, now it comes down to even more fit and fiddle, dude. We got to work on the fender bottom edges because of how they're kinked in. Mm-hmm. It's on both sides, so yes, that needs to be done. Other than that, it's just going to be a matter of going in and just working it and working it to get it done. And that's going to be individual to each car.
Yes.
I mean, you're not going to be able to tell people what's going to be this or it's going to be this.
We can put this on Gene and Vince's and every cut that we made has been wrong.
Exactly. It could fit completely different on their car because of the way these things are constructed.
Yes.
So I guess basically what we'll do now is we'll just kind of pull everything off, get a look at what we got, which I think looked pretty dang cool.
Yeah.
Tighten everything up, and then we'll just close this bad boy out because I have a surprise for you.
Ooh, I like surprises.
Yes, it's going to be a nice surprise. I'm going to be happy with it.
All right.
So button up, and then we'll finish up.
Woo! Ooh, shiny.
Shiny and cool.
Yes.
This is the stuff from Street and Track that I've been talking to you about that said we were going to get in.
Mm-hmm.
We're still going to get some brakes for it. Not sure who we're going to go with on the brakes. And we may even have to change up our idea about wheels and tires as well. Because I'm thinking that with this suspension, we probably ought to go with a little bit bigger brake.
Especially because how I drive.
I like speed.
Hopefully I can get you some classes to teach you how to really drive on a like road situation. But anyway, this stuff is from Street and Track. And obviously, extremely cool.
Yes.
It's a coilover system that basically takes all the stress off the upper control arm. So it's a nice system. Mm-hmm. I think you're going to be real happy with it. How are you with the race apron?
I love it.
Now, here's the funny thing about your car. Basically, you have a really nice car from about right here.
Yeah, this line back.
Line right
there. Yeah.
This way.
Yeah, pretty much everything in front of this doubles the value of the car.
We were talking about that off camera, folks, that basically what we're doing with this car, everything that we're adding to it is making it far more valuable than the entire car.
This system is about three times more than what I...
What you pay for the car.
No, actually, I got paid to take this.
So that's true. Somebody paid him to take the car off. So mm-hmm. In any case, like we said, his car is worth more now than it
ever has been or probably will be.
No, we're going to finish this thing up. It's going to be really cool.
Parts alone, it'll be worth more.
Yeah, the parts are probably worth more than the whole car, but we got pretty cool plans for it.
Yes.
I mean, we got, you know, we're going to make the Punisher out of it.
Mm-hmm.
So we got things that we plan to do. In any case, race apron, a few more details to do, but I like the way it fits up. Yes. It's okay.
And it works a whole lot better than my ghetto apron.
Yeah, the ghetto apron you did was pretty atrocious. But
we're good for cooling.
Yeah, well, this one should work even better because, you know, you're fully opened up in there now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, folks, that's our show for this week. Do us a favor and come back and watch next time on
AutoRestoMod.
Have a great week.
Good on.
Go take and I don't even want to know what you're going to do.
Don't mind the white paint. It's not paint.
This is supposed to be the blank spot where there's copy and stuff. This is the shop cat. Right? You shop kitty? That's the shop kitty butthole. As long as the camera's on, she'll be up here.